morning, everybody. Welcome back to the ICT classes. So today is the last class of ICT, and in today's class we will be discussing task 4, sort and print of chapter 5, collecting information. So this is the last task in chapter 5, that is sort and print. So in this lesson I will show you guys how it is being done, that is sorting and printing, how it is being done in Microsoft Excel. So I will minimize this one and I will take my Excel. So here I have all the information that I have written in the previous week, and I have changed the style. I have selected everything. I have selected the information. Go to Home tab. Here on the Styles group, Format as Table, click that one. I can change my style. And while you are changing your style, you have to tick, there will be a Create Table box. In that box you have to tick mark My table has headers. Only then these will be coming, okay? These arrow marks will be coming, okay? So that is how you change the style. I have taught you in the previous class how to do it. If you have any information, go to the link and check that video. So we have the table here. And in today's class, what we are going to do is, first we are going to sort it. So here I have, you can see the name. And near to the name, you can see that small arrow mark. So here I can sort A to Z, that is you can sort it from A to Z in alphabetical order, you can sort it. So I'm going to press that one, A to Z. So you can see the name is changed, the order is changed. First Alex, then Kim, Lisa, Marco, Stella and Tom. So it is in alphabetical order. Now it is in alphabetical order. And also all the information, all these information is also being changed. You can see Alex's telephone number, home address, everything is in the first line, right? So that's how you sort it. So suppose that if you want to sort it from Z to A, I'm going to press Z to A. So see, first name is Tom and his information is here. His record is here, and Stella, Marco, Lisa, Kim, Alex. So everything is in the order. And so this is called as sorting, that is the name of our task, sorting, okay? And if you want to do another thing, you can see here all the names, right? So suppose that you only need boys, so you can avoid the girls here, Antik, Lisa and Stella, so only boys, right? Alex, Kim, Marco and Tom, and then I'm going to press OK. So here you can see only the boys, and it is in the sorted order from Z to A. And if you want it from A to Z, okay, Alex, Kim, Marco, Tom. Okay, so this is called as filtering, this process, that is this one. This is called as filtering. You have just applied a filter to your database table based on the content of one field. So based upon this, you have filtered it. That is, you have filtered it. Your filtering is you only need boys. So you got only boys right here. Okay. So this is called as filtering. You can sort it. You can filter your data or information. Okay. Is that clear? Sorting means this one, sort A to Z, sort Z to A. And this one is filtering, either the boys, either the girls, whatever you want, you can filter your information. But even if you are filtering it, the rest of the records are not deleted. They are still there, but they are not displayed, that's all. Okay, so I will show you. So if you are pressing select all, I'm pressing select all, so all, girls and both the girls and boys are here. I'm pressing OK. It is back to the normal state, okay? So it is not being deleted, it is still there. We are just applying a filter, okay? So we know what is sorting and filtering. Next one is printing. So I want to print this table, okay? So if I want to print this table, I'm going to File. Here I have the print option. I'm going to press print. And here I'm going to select whatever printer is connected. I have to select that printer. And then here there are two orientations. Either you can select the portrait orientation, check here, it is the page is being changed. Or if I'm pressing landscape, see, there are two types of orientation. landscape orientation is best for the tables. So I have pressed landscape orientation. And if this table, if it is a big table, it won't be fitting in your A4 size paper. So for that, you have to press fit sheet on one page so that that big table will be fitting into your A4 sheet. Okay, here there is no need because the table is so small. Okay, and then how many copies do you need? If you need 2 copies, you can write 2 copies there. And what you have to do is click print, so this will be printed. So these are the tasks for today. So we have sorted it, we have filtered it, and we have tried how to print. So if you have a printer, I want you guys to print it in landscape mode. The same example, I want you guys to print it in landscape mode. You can give any style, whatever style you want, but print it in your print it in landscape mode. And also apply this one, boys. The filtering is boys, so boys, and sort is from A to Z. Press OK. Do this and then take a printout. If you don't have a printout, just take a picture, just take a photo of this one and send it to me. So that's all for today's class. Thank you so much. So the main difference between an input device and an output device is that input device is used to enter the some data to the computer like a keyboard, mouse, microphone, and the output device, it is used to get information from the computer, that is example printer, speaker and headphones. I hope you guys understood the difference between input device and the output devices. Okay, now we are moving on to hardware and software. So hardware, first one is hardware. Hardware is any part of the computer that you can physically touch, pick up, hold or move. That is any part of the computer that you can touch. Okay, So suppose that a system unit, monitor, mouse, printer, keyboard, any one of these, you can touch all these things, right? All these devices, you can touch it, you can pick it up, you can hold, or you can move it, right? So such a device is called as hardware, okay? So I hope you got the point. The hardware is any part of the computer, it should be a part of the computer that you can physically touch, pick up, hold or move. And examples of hardware devices are system unit, monitor, mouse, printer and keyboard. Okay. Next one is software. So software is the application or programming instructions needed to make the computer hardware do useful work. So computer software, in short we can say something, the computer software you can't touch it, hardware you can touch it, you can feel it and everything, but software you can touch it. That is the main difference between the hardware and software. So by definition we will be telling software is application or programming instruction needed to make the computer hardware do useful work. So we want to make the computer hardware do something, okay? For that we will be having applications or programming instructions. So such a programming instruction or application is called as a software, okay? For example, if you are considering the example, you will be knowing it much better. Examples are Microsoft Word, Microsoft PowerPoint, Microsoft Excel, games that you have installed in the computer. All these are the examples of software. So suppose that if we are taking Microsoft Word, you can't touch Microsoft Word, right? You can't even hold Microsoft Word, or you can, you know, do anything. You cannot feel it, right? It is inside, something inside the computer. So it is called as a software. So you can identify the hardware and software by using this, if you can touch it or if you can't touch it. That is the main difference, okay? So software means you can't touch it and it will be inside your computer like a program, like the games that you are playing, or Microsoft Excel, Microsoft PowerPoint, anything that is inside your computer is called as a software that you can't touch. It will be programs, okay? But hardware means any physical part of the computer that you can touch, pick up, hold or move, okay? That is the difference between hardware, like a monitor, like a mouse, like a printer, okay? So this is the main difference between hardware and software. I hope you guys understood. So in today's class we have discussed about different parts of the computer, that is the devices. I have shown you the pictures and you know some of the devices, and some of the devices are new to you, okay? And in the next section, we have discussed what is a computer. And next one was input device and output device. And the last ones were hardware and software. I hope everybody knows a clear picture of what is the difference between all these things. Okay. So that is all for today. Thank you so much. Bye.